This is probably the most anticipated light Emisar has released. This small, highly customizable triple emitter light offers high output, great value, and a host of super cool new features in a package that may just be EDC perfection for many. I'll admit, for me personally, I don't care for 14500 lights. I much prefer the increased power of 18650s. But what sets this apart is its advanced multi-fuel high efficiency boost driver designed by community specialist The Freeman, meaning this light can run off of standard AA cells, making it really stand out amongst Tank's lineup. Let's just go ahead and start with the driver and performance breakdown. If you run this light off of a 14500 cell, it's more or less the traditional Emisar hot rod. Here, the three Nichia 219Bs offer an impressive 1530 lumens on turbo, and Eneloop will provide 665 lumens, which is quite impressive for a single AA. The highly efficient switching driver results in great runtimes and runs less hot than its FET competitors, though it's definitely still quite toasty on turbo. The 14500 still drops quickly, as expected, down to 500 lumens after 5 minutes, and it varied between 260 and 380 lumens in my runtime test. The Eneloop cell sustained a flat 240 lumens throughout the run, about 50 minutes before it died down. I will link below a detailed breakdown of this driver on budget light form by its designer, The Freeman, a very knowledgeable, longtime flashlight modder. Significantly, this light features high dynamic range capabilities, allowing it to cover a huge range, from turbo to so low that I literally cannot see or measure the output anymore. Perfect for moonlight snobs. Even better, it does all of this without the PWM, ripple, or instability found on other Hank lights at these low modes. This is enabled by one significant update for Anduril flashlights as a whole that is debuting in this model, the inclusion of an ATtiny AVRDD series microcontroller, a new, more advanced MCU that offers improvements and more features over the older 1634 and 1616 controllers found in other lights. This signals a new era for Emisar Noctagon lights and will be used in Gen 3 models going forward. While Toykeeper explains that this upgrade permits this light's multi-fuel feature set and allows for other more advanced hardware configurations. It is, in theory, the MCU that will be used for future Anduril lights across the board, which basically means even better flashlights for us to enjoy. Hank is still working to offer a new flashing kit for this light series, which I am personally hoping will also be widely compatible with others utilizing this MCU. So, all of that is super nerdy, but what really makes this light cool in my opinion is really just the collaborative effort taken here by the manufacturer and several passionate community members to produce a light which stands out for its features and performance. This is really a special light, even amongst Hank's already very interesting lineup. The triple optic used here is of high quality and produces a beautiful clean and fairly floody beam with these Nichia 219B emitters. It's really great for EDC and general usage. The default optic is the Karklo 10511, while you can order throwier or floodier optics if you prefer, but this is definitely the sweet spot in my opinion. The light ships with Anduril 2, in this case a new build which retains all of its features between both low voltage AA and high voltage 14500. Pretty cool. There is a new, like, quick ramp when turning on or off and cycling between stepped modes, which does look nice, but it can be a bit confusing honestly when rapidly switching or setting modes. Overall though, it runs very smoothly and, well, it's Anduril, so of course it's cool. I guess the build of the light is last this time. It's well built, as usual. Very small and portable, and optionally features a magnet in the tail cap. The glass used for the lens has a strong green AR coating, which helps to improve the beam coloration. The only complaint I have are the O-rings, which are the same as those used on the D2. They suck. They break super easily. I had one snap when removing the tail cap, and then I broke the next one just trying to replace it. So, only two extras are included, but I would probably try to find a higher quality replacement because these are just not gonna last. Oh, and there are six RGB auxiliaries in the front. Great. And also the option for mirrored RGB aux in the side switch, which is super cool. I do still prefer the solid color, honestly, but this does make for a really awesome battery voltage indicator. Well, this is an awesome light. One of the best and most refined lights Hank has ever released. It's an easy recommendation for flashlight nerds wanting, well, a small AA-sized light. For as much as there is to say, there kind of isn't much to say because it's just really good. Personally, I will probably be selling mine. For one, the awesome red color wasn't available when I ordered, so yeah, I'm sad about that. But really, as great as the dual fuel feature is, I just prefer to carry a larger 18650 light, which provides significantly more power and is already plenty small and lightweight. This smaller 14500 model, 14500 in general, it just doesn't offer much for me. But if you do prefer that form factor, or even if you want a crazy Android light like this but would rather use a nickel metal hydride battery, well, then this is a fantastic option. This guy starts at $35 and, depending on options, goes up to like 60 bucks. It's an excellent value, and again, a really easy recommendation for those looking for an enthusiast light. Of course, if even that's too much, you can check out these 14500 sized Anduril hot rods from Workos, the TS10 V2 and HD10, which come in under $25.